example, we can put them in German here, right? Or French, or even Japanese, right? Pretty cool. I'm going to stay in English. And so this is iPod. Playlists, artists, songs, settings, very, very simple. A breakthrough in consumer electronics user interfaces. The scroll wheel lets us not only rapidly find our music, but lets us use iPod with one hand. So, that is iPod. We think we got a breakthrough in user interfaces to where it is now accessible to everybody to have 1,000 songs and find them and navigate them faster than if you only had 10 or 15 on a much simpler device. A big breakthrough, Apple's legendary ease of use applied to a consumer electronics device. Third breakthrough, auto-sync. So let me start by backing up to iTunes. iTunes, as I mentioned, has been an unabashed success. We have distributed over 6 million copies of iTunes. Our users love it. They can build music libraries, digital music libraries, right on their Macs by ripping their CDs. They can burn CDs. They can listen to internet radio stations. They can make playlists, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Great visualizations. iTunes has been wonderful. Today, we're pleased to announce iTunes 2. iTunes 2 has the three features that our users have been asking for most, and they are MP3 CD burning right from iTunes, crossfading, and an equalizer. So let me give you a real quick demo of these three things. Let me launch iTunes again. For those of you that were watching carefully, it was iTunes 2 that I launched before. And let me go start with the crossfader. I'll go to a playlist like Monday Morning, and I'll play a Beatles song, and I'll skip to the end of it so you can hear the crossfading. I'll do it again for you. Whoops. Do that. So, crossfading. Now let me show you the equalizer. This is flat. Two of these. But we also have a bunch of presets. So, that's the equalizer. Now, MP3 CD burning. Let me pick a playlist. Let me pick a Road Trip here. I've got 152 songs in Road Trip, about 10 times as many as will fit on a normal CD. So I'm going to put in a CDR disc, just a normal, 50-cent CDR disc, blank one. And I'm going to just say on Road Trip, let me go ahead and burn this. And iTunes will recognize that all those songs can't fit on a regular CD, and it's going to say all the songs in this playlist will not fit on an audio CD. iTunes can create MP3 CDs, which can be played in MP3 CD players. Which do you want? So it can put all the songs on an MP3 CD, or just as many as will fit on a regular audio CD. And if I push MP3 CD, it will go ahead and burn one of those. Okay? Very simple. So that... last feature, actually, is we now support, again, international characters in iTunes. And, we can just pick one of these if we want. But you get the idea. So, okay, MP3 CD burning, crossfading, and an equalizer. These are the hot new features of iTunes 2. It runs on Mac OS 9 and Mac OS 10, and it's a free download. We'll be releasing it in early November on www.apple.com. iTunes 2. But those aren't the coolest feature of iTunes 2. The coolest feature of iTunes 2 is we have designed it to be used in conjunction with the iPod. The two work intimately together. And the coolest new feature is auto-sync. Remember I said earlier that devices don't know about iApps. Well, we're changing that. Because iTunes, not only does iTunes know all about iPod, but iPod knows all about iTunes. And so when you plug in the FireWire cable of your iPod into your Mac, automatically iTunes is launched, and all of your iTunes songs and playlists are automatically downloaded into iPod. You don't have to sit there dragging things over. Everything, your whole music library, is automatically downloaded into iPod, and as we saw, at blazing FireWire speed, about a half a second per song. Okay? Now, what happens if subsequent to that, you add some new music to iTunes, you rearrange your playlist, make new playlists, delete playlists, etc.? Well, every time you plug iPod back into your Mac, it automatically updates with the latest and greatest information from iTunes, all automatically. And so when you plug it in, you'll see something like this. It's updating the songs on iPod, and when it's done, iPod update is complete. And if you, most likely, if you've only added a few albums, you know, iPod is so fast, FireWire is so fast, just literally takes a few seconds. It's amazing. So what I'd like to do now is show you. I've got an iPod here that I have been using. I've got a brand new one right here. And let's go ahead and let me just show you that it's a brand new one. We turn it on. And let me go into playlists. You notice I have no playlist there. And I'll go into songs, and I have no songs. So this is a brand new iPod. I'm going to take it over here, and what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go just simply plug it into iTunes. We've got the computer on the screen here. There we go. I'm going to plug it into iTunes. I'll just plug it in right now. It'll take a second to recognize it.